Hey guys, how's it going? This is Austin Reed. Hope you guys are having a wonderful day. Now, I've been getting a lot of requests lately to teach you guys how to self-host your own n8n automation server. So today we're going to go over that. For those of you guys who don't know what n8n is, it's basically like Make or Zapier, but you can do a lot more with it. It's a lot more flexible, and you control your own data if you self-host it, and it's really cheap compared to the other alternatives. If you guys want to skip the video and just go straight to the installing part, I do have instructions down below. However, if you guys want to understand just a little bit about what you're doing, I will keep the video quick, but I'm going to explain a little bit about what it is we're actually doing line by line so that you guys can actually understand the process of how a few of these things work. So, yeah, without further ado, let's jump right in. The first thing you're going to need is a server. Now it has to be an Ubuntu server, but you could do it on any kind of host you want. This one is Volta, but I mean DigitalOcean, AWS, Google Cloud, pretty much anything can host, an Ubuntu server. You can even do this on your own laptop if you wanted to. You can just reformat a hard drive, laptop in the corner, and then have like free automation set up in the corner or something. Anyway, you do need a domain name. So we went with horizon-dev.net. It's one of our test URLs that we use. And you only need one DNS record, and you're only pointing to here. So you're going to do an A record with this IP address, which is the IP address of your server. And that's it, basically. So for those of you guys who want to know what that looks like, it just looks like this: A record, URL, IP address. Save. Easy enough. So let's jump right in. We're going to SSH into the server. I like to use PuTTY. You guys can use whatever you want. You can use a command prompt if you want. I'm going to copy the IP, open it up, copy that, log in as root, and we're going to put the password. For those of you guys who don't know, right click is how to paste the password in PuTTY. And we're going to get started. So I'm gonna switch over to this other screen here because it's a little easier to see kind of what's going on with the instructions. So step one done, step two done, step three done. All right, now we're gonna update the server and install Docker. Okay, so while this is installing, I'll kind of explain what's going on. This basically just updates, your Ubuntu server with all the latest stuff. They don't come installed that way. This one is going to install Docker and Docker Compose. Now, Docker, what it is it's like a CD, you can think about it. So you can put, programs or a server or whatever you want on that CD and put it in any computer, and it'll automatically run. It's basically the same as Docker. Now, n8n has done us a favor and they made it their own Docker CD or image that we can use to install our stuff. Now, Docker Compose, it's just instructions on how to use the CD. So you can see those instructions down here. I'll get to that in a minute. But basically, you can control how that CD is being run, or how the application is being run. Okay, so I'm going to fast forward until this installs. All right, so when you guys encounter this screen, you're just going to hit OK. And OK, just enter twice, basically. And we should be just about done to install Docker. So let's copy that. Give it a sec. Bam. That one will be a little bit faster. Got to put yes on this question. Some more screens are going to pop up for a second. Hit yes. Just hit enter a bunch of times. All right. Now we're going to start Docker. So it's already started, doesn't say anything. All right, now we have to set up Docker Compose. So here's the Docker Compose file. In here, you're going to want to change a couple things: the user and password. For this, these here need to be the same as these down here. So see it says secure password, but here is secure password, n8n. These got to be the same. These need to be your URL to your website. So whatever it is that you pointed the DNS, it could be n8n.horizondev.net or whatever, change all of the ones that say horizon-dev, this one too, to reflect what it is, what website you want it to be at. Okay. Now we're going to nano Docker Compose YML. So we're going to nano, for those of you guys who don't know, it's how you open and create text files in Linux. Okay. So basically we're saying, hey, open this file, and if it doesn't exist, create it. So we're just going to copy paste that. Create a new file, blank, right? We're going to copy all this code. We're just going to paste it in. And to save it, you go Control S, and to exit, you go Control X. Okay, so that's already done. Now we're going to build the Docker. So we're going to build the CD so that we can all put it in whenever we want, right? So Docker-compose up builds the CD. If you want to see what's going on in all the logs, you would just do that. I don't recommend it though, because you can't exit it out without stopping the program. So we just run that. It's going to install n8n for you. It's going to install Postgres for you, which is a database that n8n is going to use, right? So it's really, really good stuff. You can see it's just downloading a bunch of stuff and installing it. So that's super cool. It does all the work for you. It's beautiful. All right, so the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to check to see if it's actually working. So we're going to switch screens over here. We're going to go to the URL. We're going to paste it there, and we're going to go double dot 5678. How do I know that? Well, if you go here, it'll tell you right here, 5678, right? Don't really want to change that number. You kind of want to leave it there. But we're going to hit enter, and it should bring up n8n. A little slow the first time. That's fine. We're not going to set it up now. We just wanted to make sure that it starts. Okay. We're not done yet. So we're going to go back over to this screen. I'm going to minimize this guy. This is done. We built it. We checked to see if it works. Now we have to install Nginx and certbot. So Nginx, what it does is it's like you have a URL and you need to tell it where to go. So basically, we're connecting this URL to this application, which is n8n. What Certbot does is it deploys your SSL security certificate so that hackers have a harder time getting into things. So they're both kind of important. So, yeah, we're going to do that. We're going to hit yes, okay. Okay. Give it a sec. Okay, now we're going to open port 80. Now we're opening this so that we could start the SSL authentication. Later, we're going to close it. Why? Because hackers get in through port 80. So we only want to open the configure stuff. We're going to stop Nginx because it automatically starts itself when you install it. And then we're going to grab a SSL. Now, you have to change this URL to be whatever URL yours is. Okay. So we're going to just grab that, paste that in. This will be quite quick. Da-da-da. Have to enter an email, test@test.com. Gonna hit, what is that? Yes on the terms of service. No, I don't want to submit this email. If this doesn't work, then your DNS settings are wrong, just so you know. So if this doesn't work, go all the way back to step two and fix step two, and then go back down to the certbot. Okay. But it seems like it worked just fine. Okay. Now we're going to generate the SSL. So we have the key. Now we have to generate it. Now with this command, the larger this number at the end is, the more secure your server is technically when it comes to SSL. The problem is the larger that number is, the longer things take. So we don't want things to take 2 days. I've waited hours for these things to generate sometimes. Sometimes they take a while. So we're going to keep it at 2048, which is still secure, but not too secure. You know what I mean? It's like, it's not going to be too slow. So give this a minute. All right, so now I'm finished. That one took about maybe 2 minutes. So it was a little slow. I mean, relatively speaking. But all right, the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna configure Nginx. So we're gonna be like, hey, this is the URL and this is where the application is connected to. So we're gonna nano again. So we're gonna create a text file in this folder in etc Nginx sites enabled called horizon-dev.net. Change the name of the file to be the name of your website. And there we go. Cool. Now on this, okay, I'm gonna big screen this real quick and let me see if I can full width this too. Look, you need to copy and paste this into a Word document and replace all of the horizon-dev.net. So there's one here, one here, one here, right? There is, I mean, they're all over the place. You just gotta kind of look. This is the link to the N8N. Okay, just so you know. These are headers here, so N8N knows where, like, what website it is. It's pretty important. Here we have horizon-dev.net at the bottom too. So you gotta make sure you replace those. Okay, it's really important. These are just server settings. So let's copy that. Paste that in. Remember, Control S, Control X. There we go. We're out now. Now let's open up the instructions again. Go back to half page. And then we're going to restart Nginx. So we're almost done. Systemctl restart Nginx. Okay. Now we have to deny port 80 because we don't want hackers getting in. So we're denying that, and then we're allowing port 443, which allows for HTTPS traffic, and now it should work. So let's go to the other screen, see if it works. So we'll just open a new tab, we'll go https://horizon-dev.net/setup, and there we go. That's basically it. Everything should be set up. You guys should have the proper webhook URLs and everything set up properly for this to be a full-time production environment for your N8N. So I hope that this helped you guys out, and you guys have a wonderful day.